So actually, I did not say that. What I said was that he outed himself as a dog whistle white nationalist because he said that Ronald Reagan was his mentor or somebody that he modeled himself after. Since that time, we've learned that actually Ronald Reagan actually called black people monkeys. And so with that, you know, people weren't familiar with Ronald Reagan's history, the fact that he didn't stand for the Civil Rights Act, the fact that he actually did have prejudice towards people of color, African Americans in particular. So I do think that that Governor Hogan needs to actually rescind those remarks, and I stand by what I said.
That is the former Maryland Democratic Party chairman and widow of Congresswoman Elijah Cummings, Maya Rockeymoore Cummings, who kicked off her campaign for the special election to fill the rest of her husband's term. As Maryland Democratic Party chairman last year, she made some comments, the dog whistle comments, about Governor Larry Hogan. This was in her position as Maryland Democratic Party chairman. And so this is why this is news today, as Maya Rockeymoore Cummings.
And she stands by it. And she said right there to Phil Yakubowski that she stands by those comments, Robert. And the significance of that is any objective viewpoint of Governor Larry Hogan, particularly since two elections have shown the support he's received from the African-American vote, which is historic in the state for a Republican. How in the world would you suggest he's dog whistling white nationalism and be a serious candidate?
And yet this will play to some of her base, right, Secor?
Of course it will. But I mean, I'm talking about a serious candidate. You have fringe candidates who will try to play to fringe bases. But to somehow suggest that a governor who during the riots of 2015 put his office over in Sandtown, Winchester, who was seen on multiple occasions doing things like that in different aspects of Maryland, Prince George's County, Baltimore City, and other areas with African Americans. I mean, what Governor Hogan basically did was say, I adopt the Ronald Reagan philosophy of politics. That in no way is suggesting any white nationalism, white supremacist thing. So, like I say, if this is the way she wants to kick off her campaign, it is really isolating her potential.
Let's move beyond the campaign. You have Congressman Cummings' best friend and his predecessor, Kwesi Mfume, who is running in the race. And also Larry Gibson, who is the congressman's good friend, is backing Kwesi Mfume.
Let me just say personally, I know all of them, and I understand that's kind of a narrative. That best thing friend thing is kind of overplayed. I mean, they were good friends. But I know both of them very well, and kind of, let's just say best friend is a little overblown. But yes, they were very, very good friends.
Does Kwesi Mfume stay in the race?
Kwesi Mfume stays in the race. And I truly believe that what we're going to see is maybe some of the other candidates, maybe a delegate Talmadge Branch, not jump in. We still have to hear from State Senator Jill P. Carter.
She's going to announce next week, and I asked her today, does this change her plans? And she says absolutely not.
So this should be Monday.
It is not about Monday. It is not about political opportunism. It's about preserving the legacy of Elijah Cummings, Perrin J. Mitchell, and her father,
And I only say this, Robert, that the sympathy factor that would normally go to the spouse of someone who passes in Congress, you've seen this around the country, where you have a spouse or a child seek the seat of, you know, their relative who's died while they're in office, would generally be given to a Dr. Maya Rockeymoore Cummings. However, comments like we just played, the fact that she threatened state legislators during the whole lead up to the new speaker, Adrian Jones, candidacy, when state legislators were attempting to negotiate and she inserted that she might not give money to... All that puts her in a different position politically than an aggrieved or a grieving spouse.
The C4 Show will return tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL, and we'll have special live coverage starting at 10 of the Senate Intelligence Committee hearings on impeachment.